Just another sunny day. In this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to distribute objects evenly along any path. And you can even edit the path while the objects stay evenly distributed. And if you duplicate the objects, they instantly distribute themselves automatically. Okay, why would you need this? I'm thinking of a chain of lights. Maybe you can use this technique for an animated zipper, or you need a dotted line with custom shapes. You can easily create all of this inside After Effects, no external plugins, maybe with just this little expression snippet. But don't worry, it's really easy to understand, and you can even copy and paste it without any expression knowledge. Let's jump right into After Effects. This is the path we're gonna distribute the objects along. I'm gonna select it, and the only essential trick you should know is to click on this button. And after doing this, we get a null that loops along the path. Well, we do need some more steps to distribute multiple objects along the path. But let me first tell you where to find this panel. You just go to Window and look at the bottom of this menu, where you can find all the scripts in one place. And what we need is the Create Nulls from Paths script. It's a script that is built in since After Effects 2018, and it's so powerful that it would need another video tutorial to explain all its possibilities. But for our purpose, you just need the Trace Path button only. Now, let's go back to the null object created by this script. It moves and loops along the path. And when we have a closer look at its effect controls, we can find a custom effect with two attributes that control the expressions added to the null object. The progress slider determines the null's position on the path. And the script already created two keyframes that animates the null. Value 0 is where the null object starts, and 100 where the null reaches the end of the path. Let's switch off loop and delete the progress keyframes. So, when we want to evenly distribute three objects along the path manually, we have to put this null object at position 0, where the path starts, duplicate it, put it at position 100, that's where the path ends, duplicate it again, and position it halfway the path, which is position 50. We can now see that three evenly distributed objects divide the path into two sections of the same length. This is the first half, and that's the second half. They maybe don't look the same length, but believe me, it's just an optical illusion. Consequently, we can assume that five objects divide the path into four sections of the same length. 100 divided by 4 is 25. So the first null stays at position 0, the next at 100, then we have to change the next null's position to 25 as calculated before, duplicate it, add 25, duplicate it again, and add another 25. For just a few objects, this manual technique should be fine. But wouldn't it be cool if the objects distribute themselves automatically along the path? What we just need is simple math, and a very, very easy expression snippet. But let me first delete all the nulls except of one, and replace it with a footage I prepared by alt-dragging it onto the null object. It's not visible yet. That's because the opacity is 0. Let's crank it up to 100, and we can see a happy person dancing. By the way, that's the way I felt when I discovered the technique I'm showing you right now. Normally, the dancer should be at position 0, like the null object we replaced, and to fix this, I'm gonna change the anchor point position to its original values. I do it manually here, but you can also right-click on it and press reset in the pop-up menu. Maybe let's scale it down a bit, like this. What we have found out so far is that three objects divide the path into two segments. 5 objects into 4, and probably 100 objects will divide the path into 99 segments. So you divide the path by 1 less than the number of objects you want to distribute evenly. Let's create an expression out of our discovery. I'm gonna open up the progress attribute, click into the expression window, and delete the existing lines created by the script. Instead, I'm typing in 100, which represents the complete path, divided by less 1 than all available layers in the composition, so I'm gonna type in this comp.numlayers That's the code for the layer count in this composition. Less one, so minus one. But because the path layer doesn't count as an object to distribute, we have to subtract another one. So let's change this to minus two. Let's see what happens. Error. That's because we have two layers available in this composition, and when you subtract two from two, the result is zero. And everyone who is a little familiar with math knows that any number divided by zero is illegal. Because one object to distribute doesn't make sense anyway, let's go back to our example with five objects and see what happens. I'm gonna duplicate this layer until we have five footage layers. The result in the progress attribute is 25, which sounds familiar from the manual technique we applied before. To distribute the layers along the path, we can make use of these numbers. Each of these numbers are assigned to a specific layer. And each layer number is represented by this little code, index, which in this case is 1 according to the current layer. We can now multiply the index with the rest. Let's wrap this in parentheses, and nothing happens. The layer is still on position 25. 25 times 1 is still 25. But we want to have layer 1 start at position 0, so let's subtract 1 from index. Open parentheses, index, minus 1, closing parentheses, and layer 1 is positioned at 0. 1 minus 1 is 0, and 0 multiplied by anything is always 0. Let's select the progress attribute, go to edit, click on copy expression only, select the remaining footage layers, go back to edit again, select paste, and boom, every object is evenly distributed along the path. We can duplicate as many layers as we want, and every object is evenly distributed automatically. We can now grab the path, alter it like we want, and the layers stay evenly distributed. It's really cool that even the orientation is aligned to the path, but if you don't need it, you can disable the expression in the rotation attribute. Please let me know in the comment section below if you have any other idea where you can use this technique. If you found my tutorial helpful, please like my video, subscribe my channel, and turn on the bell to get notified of more tutorials. See you next time. Just another sunny day in Southern California.